A lot of players are using that team, so that's why it is called as meta team, okay? Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So today in this NeuroCloud video, I want to talk about the global meta team at this moment. So most of you guys probably already know about those tier lists that are in the internet. Yeah, they are everywhere and there are a lot of tier lists. And currently, Global have their own meta team. I mean, in the China version, there are more varieties of characters, right? So yeah, there will be more new metas in the future, but what we are going to talk about in this video is the current global meta. And I think it is also about the time to introduce my other alt accounts. If you guys still remember, I did a reroll with 9 accounts on the Aki's gacha video back then. There were 2 accounts that got hobbled, right? And here they are. This is the account that didn't get Evelyn. But after that, I played the account and I finally got my Aki here. It was 20 pull on Hubble and then 70 pull on Aki's Manor. And then the third account is this one. This one is the one that got Evelyn. I continued playing this account and then I did some gachas in Aki's Manor and I finally got Aki. It was 40 pulls on Hubble's Manor and 70 pulls in Aki's Manor, so 110 pulls in this account. Okay, I assume that you guys already watched the previous video about which character that have the higher tier list in global and which character that have the first priority to raise and stuff. Before we talk about the exact meta team with the meta character, I think we should talk about the basic of the team building. Normally, you should have like at least one healer in your party, like maybe this Persegaria or Nanaka. And then you might want to bring like at least one tank. These two are the basic of the team. One healer and one tank at least. You cannot progress without any healer. And also tank is super duper important. As far as I know, tank is really really needed because most of the warriors cannot tank properly. I mean, they could get killed easily in most stages, okay? And then, the rest of the three characters here are the one that we are going to edit. As I mentioned, Hubble is kinda like the best character at this moment in global. She's a sniper character and her ultimate is super duper good. Well, should I explain it again? If you play Genshin, it's like Fenty. You place the ultimate on one tile and all the enemies on the map will be into that point. And it could be a really game-changing ultimate. Yeah, it will affect the win or lose in a battle sometimes. Okay, so let's put Hubble here. Okay, since we are talking about the meta team, right? Let's say you are going to bring Hubble because you can reroll for Hubble, right? Now we can change the other two characters here. Normally, you can just go with 3 DPS characters like this. Yeah, I mean, one healer, Persicaria, one tank, and then the other 3 are DPS. DPS could be sniper, could be warrior, and sometimes even specialist can be a DPS. So it is like between these 3, okay? Personally, I would like to bring a warrior at least, because it will be the secondary tank other than the actual tank. And it can also do really good damage, okay? And then the last character, it could be another healer. Yeah, 2 healers are kind of more stable in some stages because you will need more heals. For example, in stages that have those pillars, towers and stuff, and it deal AoE damage over time, in that kind of stages, you might want to bring 2 healers because it will help a lot. I actually did it with only one healer, Persicaria, and it was really tough, I have to admit it. But it become much easier if you do it with 2 healers. Actually, in this account, I've been doing it with Persicaria and Florence because I got Florence accidentally when I tried to pull Aki in this account, okay? But Nanaka is better. Yeah, I have to say that. Nanaka is much better than Florence if you want to run a double healer, because Florence ultimate doesn't heal. Okay, so this is like one of the examples, 2 healers and then 2 DPS, right? The other example is you can actually still go with 2 healers and 1 specialist like this. Actually, in my China account, I tried this composition and it went really, really good. Because this Angela at 5 stars is actually quite OP. I mean, she can actually tank some damage. Yeah, as a specialist. Kinda similar to Warrior, but slightly weaker if we talk about how good a specialist can tank. But yeah, specialist can also tank some damage. This kind of composition is also very good. Two healers, one tank, one specialist, and one DPS. The DPS could be sniper or yeah, could be warrior, depend on the stage. But mostly, since Hubble is kinda too OP, I will go with just Hubble for the DPS. And then the other composition that actually could go pretty good is something like this. One healer, and then two DPS, one specialist, Angela. This one is also pretty good. This kind of team actually works pretty well in global. I mean, I've been doing this until chapter 5 in my main account with only one Persicaria, as you can see on the previous video. Okay, so actually having 3 DPS is good. Also, one support, 2 DPS is good. Angela, somehow very, very good. Her ultimate is also very good. Basically, what Angela's ultimate can do is if you pick an enemy, that enemy will remain in the map while the other enemy is kinda like disappear for several seconds. All of our character will attack that selected enemy. So yeah, like focus targeting an enemy. And this could be also a game changing ultimate other than Hubble's ultimate. And you can also go with 2 snipers, 1 warrior, which actually I did in my main account. Yep, this account. My very first account and the one that I didn't reroll account, okay? So, since this account doesn't have Aki, I can go with Betty, basically. Like this. I accidentally pulled Changxi, so I can use her and Hubble. This team could also work. Okay, let's say I want to bring 2 healers and 2 DPS like this. So what should I bring as a backup characters? You can bring Angela, because Angela is always good. Especially if she already reached 5 stars. Okay, at least 3 stars, already good enough. 5 stars, much better. So you can bring Angela, one additional healer like this. And the other one could be another sniper for the backup if Hubble is dying or something. Or could be another warrior like this. Why should I bring another healer if I already have 2 here? Okay, I already explained this many times. If one of your healers dying, you can just replace it. Yep, like this. And the healer that is in the backup seat will recover some HP. And you can use her again on the next battle, like this. So temporarily. Same thing goes to backup warrior. If your Aki is somehow dying, you can replace with the backup warrior in the battle, let Aki recover, and then you can use Aki again on the next battle. Something like that. And somehow, if you're stuck on the boss stage, if you bring Angela, you can actually try to, for example, if you think you are lacking of damage, you just can try to bring like 3 attackers like this, or you can try to bring Angela instead of Aki to get even higher survivability, because Angela will reduce the cooldown of the healers too. They will heal faster, and Hubble will be able to do more skills, and Croak will be able to recover using the first skill, you know, the self-heal and stuff, faster with Angela's buff. So yeah, that's why Angela is really good. Okay, now, since we know about the basic, so what is the meta team in global right now, actually? There will be a lot of meta teams because there is actually no one single meta team that is above everything. I think it's kinda depend on the stage, okay? The first meta team is could be something like this. 2 healers, Persicaria, 5 stars, and then Nanaka as a second healer. The tank could be Croak or could be Evelynn. If you have Evelynn, you can try to use her. But Croak is already good enough for mostly everything, as for now in global. Yeah, I know, there will be better tank in the future, like based on the China version, Clotho maybe. And then the DPS, obviously Hubble, she's a meta character which should be in the meta team. And the last one, is warrior Aki. Aki is kind of like the best warrior at this moment in global. Yeah, if you don't have Aki, you can replace Aki with Betty. Okay, so this is the first meta. What is the second meta? Here, Angela team. Still with the same two healers, one tank, Croak, a Hubble as a DPS, but instead of using Aki, you can use Angela. But this kind of team is kinda neat. A higher rarity of Angela, like at least 3 stars. If she has 5 stars, then it is perfect. Yeah. You're going to need a 5 stars Angela to make this team really, really good, because you will need to have Angela to tank some damage. So she cannot be weak. She has to be strong, this Angela. Okay? But as for now, in the beginning, this team is better. Okay? So what is the other meta? The third meta could be something like this. One healer, one Angela, two DPS, if you think you need more DPS. Actually, with only one healer, one Persicaria, I can already clear most of the stages in global, in the standard mode, okay? There was only one stage on the chapter 5 which actually need two healers, Nanaka. I already proved this. Yeah, so my main account yesterday just summoned my first Nanaka. And before I summon my Nanaka, I already cleared the chapter 5. So that's a living proof, okay? But still, in most cases, I still want to go with two healers because this is kind of like the most stable. So there is actually one more meta team, which is kind of out of the box. Okay, I know some people that actually using this setup. The warrior is Petty, the DPS is Sakuya. These two can do bleed. Sakuya is a specialist that can do bleed as a debuff. And bleed's damage is actually pretty good. If you get those, you know, the buff stacking, the function cards, you get bleed, 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 and bleed. A lot of bleeds. Bleed is going to be really good. And then Betty also have bleed here on the ultimate. Okay? So these two are kind of a really good combo. But for the function cards, you have to take those bleeds. Bleeds and bleed. Okay? Obviously, you still can bring your Hubble. For example, like this. One healer. And then Betty, Sakuya. The single healer could be Persicaria or could be Nanaka. Up to you. It's totally up to you. Basically, Nanaka have AoE heal, but weaker single target heal. Okay, when your character is dying, well, Nanaka still can use the ultimate and heal some HP, but the heal amount is not as high as Persicaria single heal. So Persicaria and Nanaka have their own pro and cons, okay? You can go with this. Betty Sakuya is a good combo, guys. If you guys are F2P and somehow only able to get Hubble as your first reroll character, and you don't have anything else, and you want to save for the future OP banners, you can go with teams like this. It's actually very interesting. Yeah, obviously, other than using Sakuya, you can use Angela. But this team is also quite interesting. I really want to try this kind of team later in the future when I have enough time to raise them, because in this Neural Cloud, you might want to go with 5 stars characters, because it will give you more algorithm slot, which give you more power, and you will need that more power to beat the hard contents in the future, or maybe even right now. The requirement for stage 5-1 is 28,000, okay? The chapter 5-6 requires 42,000. It is not a joke. You will need like at least 8,600 power on each character to get this kind of recommended power. Okay, I will give you an example. My Persicaria here is 5 stars. The intimacy is 11. Yeah, I still can raise this later. Once it become intimacy level 15, my power will get raised, because this will get level up. And then if I raise all of the skills to level 10, my power will get raised even higher. And then if I get all of these yellow with the correct sets, it will also increase my power again. And I have to raise this algorithm efficiency to 2.0x. Yeah, basically 200%. The max of this is 200%. I will get even higher power. That will go to somewhere around 8,600. or maybe 9,000. Yeah, 8,600 is already good enough. Actually, that's the recommended power you need to beat the hard stage 5-6. So yeah, that's why you want to bring 5-star characters. Even if you are using the same character as the meta teams I mentioned before, but you don't have 5 stars, the performance could be totally different compared to the all 5 stars characters. Totally different. So if you're wondering about which character should I raise and stuff, which team should I build, actually, you can use whatever you have. Yeah, it doesn't really need to follow the best meta team. If other people talk about, well, using Hubble and Aki is the best combo, actually, you don't have 100% follow that, okay? As I already proved in this account, I've been using Betty instead of Aki, and I already beat Chapter 5, at least the standard mode. All of them here, okay? And I beat this without Nanaka. Nanaka is kinda like one of the most recommended character on most meta teams. But I already proved that you still can clear the stages even without the OP meta character or the OP meta team. Meta team is something like many players use, okay? A lot of players are using that team, so that's why it is called as meta team, okay? But it doesn't mean that if small amount of people are using certain type of team, cannot be the sage, okay? In this game, you can use many characters. Even the 1-star, 2-star characters are usable. Even though I know maybe those 1 or 2-star characters are not as OP as the 3-stars, but they are still very, very usable. Well, Angela is exceptional. She is super duper good. Yeah. So I think that's all. Hopefully you guys can understand what I mean about the meta teams. Hopefully this video could help for your progress in NeuroCloud. And that's all. Thank you for watching. Please press the like button. Please press the like button if you like this video. And then don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. And especially if you want to watch more NeuroCloud videos. Yeah. So see you again next time. Bye. Ushi Bunch.